Hello, my loves. Welcome back to my channel. If we're meeting for the first time, my name is Jessica Alexandria. I'm the creator and head witch behind Bahati Life Apothecary. I'm a professional astrologer, tarot, and intuitive reader. It feels so good to have you here with me now at this moment in time. Now, I wanted to sit and pull cards with you guys for the new moon in Virgo that's happening on September 6, 2021, roughly around 8:50 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. While I sit and pull cards and shuffle, I really wanted to take my time to connect with the guides and see what it is that they had to say, what type of intuitive messages that they wanted to share with us during this time. So first things first, you guys, and I have the chart pulled up on my left, so if you see me pausing, it's because I'm trying to stop my computer screen from going black. Which is interesting that I'm about to say that, because the first vision that it is that I'm having is a person sitting in front of a mirror, which is interesting that this is the vision. I don't know if you've been following my recent uploads on my YouTube channel, but we've been talking a lot about scrying. That was one of my recent uploads. But I see someone sitting in front of a mirror and really deeply internally looking at themselves. It's like this cross-examination. And I'm seeing these flicks, these images that come up, like little messages. And as I'm saying that, the card that is the first to jump out is the card of the messenger within the gilded Lenormand. And what I'm hearing and what I'm feeling is that there's this cross-examination that you are either undergoing right now at the time of your watching this video, or at the time of the new moon, or it has something to do with the intentions that is that you're setting. As you're looking at yourself in the reflection in the mirror, or as you're kind of reflecting at, you know, reflecting upon your life and your journey up until this point, it's very self-reflective. And I feel like this moment or this metaphor is symbolic for something that occurred, almost like a tower-like moment that occurred that is causing you to put things into perspective. And as I'm saying that, the next card that jumped out is the Scythe. So recently, there had to have been some type of abrupt endings or changes, things that were cut from your life, things that, what I'm hearing, the word that I've heard was inescapable. They were inescapable events that almost seem very fated. Of course, we have free will, but it's our choices. There's our ability to choose. It's what we decide to choose when things happen, how we decide to react. Are we reacting from a higher place, or are we reacting from a trauma place? And those reactions will ultimately shape our destiny, will ultimately shape our experiences here on Earth. Spirit is saying that there are a series of events or a major circumstance that erupted in your life that has you cross-examining your reaction to it, to them, or you're watching how someone reacts to you, how someone reacts to your boundaries, to your self-protection, to you asserting your needs, to you asking for what it is that you want. Spirit is saying that there is no right or wrong, but there is a message of observing it and acknowledging it and coming to terms with whatever that is. This is where the mirror, I'm seeing someone sitting in front of the mirror. Now, you may actually have done this. If not, it's definitely a reflection. Look, my loves, you have the owl and the woman. So these cards are about true observation. And also, I don't know if I said this, but I saw the mirror was in the dark. It's interesting that the owl is the bird that decided to show up, because the owl is the one who sees the best in the dark. There's no need to be afraid or to be fearful or to shudder or to shy away from what you are going to see as you peer into your own darkness or as you peer into the darkness of another. There's this really strong message about the darkness. And this is not something that is evil or malicious by any stretch of the imagination, but if left unchecked, that darkness can consume you and can consume your light. And the reality is that regardless of our belief systems, regardless of our background, regardless of our intention, if we're not healing the shadow aspects within ourselves, we can really fall victim to our own fears that will fuel us into self-destructive ways or self-destructive patterns, or it will guide us into making choices that do not define or don't reflect our highest hopes or a higher love or a higher vibration. Spirit is saying at the time of the new moon, we are giving you, or we have given you, an opportunity to not only observe the shadow within yourself, but also to observe the shadow within others, because there's a strong connection to this mirror. So whenever I'm seeing this mirror activity or this mirror message or metaphor, sometimes it reminds me of twin flames and soulmates, or the partnerships or the people that are in our lives that reflect our current status quo, like our current state of mind, and our relationships with those people reflect our relationship with ourselves. So Spirit is giving you a strong message right now to take the time out to receive and to observe these quick messages as they're coming through. Now, these are going to show up as triggers in your life. They're also going to show up in your own reactions. So that's the first message that I really wanted to bring to you guys. There's also the second thing that I'm hearing is no judgment. And I also heard the word no fly zone, or words no fly zone. And as I say that, here comes a flying ship. So it's funny because Spirit is wanting to tell you, or the guides are wanting to tell you, that whatever you're observing in another person or whatever you're absorbing within yourself, it's, you don't want to judge those aspects that show up. You don't want to be harsh or abrasive to them, but you do want to have a healthy level of a boundary that says this is a no-fly zone. In order for this to work out, in order for this to progress and move forward, in order for me to feel healthy and vibrant, these are certain things that I expect, or things that it is that I need in order to move forward. The thing is that not everybody is going to meet you there. Some of your requests, my loves, and this is going to be a tough message for some of you guys to receive, but some of your requests are no-fly zones for other people, because your requests or your expectations may not always, let's have an honest moment here, there's a reason why no judgment is coming through. Some of your requests and your own expectations may not be coming from the most higher spaces of love and light. They could be coming from your own shadow self. And when you have people or others around you who are speaking of their own boundaries or talking about their own limitations, fingers crossed that they're doing it in a place of higher vibration, love, and light. But if you, again, are making choices and decisions based upon quick reaction, this is a chance for you to observe, without judgment, your own no-fly zones, and work to heal them, to work to come to a resolution with them. Why is this? Because with the word no-fly zone, if these are things that you, these barriers that you create, your abundance, your growth, your connections, your relationships, your health, and your happiness can only go so far, because there are certain strings and obstacles and webs and booby traps that you have set into place that make it so that people can't get to you, that they can't reach you, regardless of whatever their intention is. And this is really why Spirit is saying, take this time under the light of the new moon, or the lack of light of the new moon, and really sit and observe your own no-fly zones. Are they healthy? Are they healthy? Or do they penetrate and destroy healthy relationships? Do they destroy your hopes and your wishes? Do they destroy your growth and your talents? And are they things that you've set into place because you are holding harder on your fears and your past stories or your past conditioning or your subconscious fears and your subconscious desires that you are suppressing and trying to hold back? Look, the maze and the moon came up twice. Now again, these are things that are dark. The book is closed, it's dark. The moon comes up twice from the darkness. The maze is the things that we have to navigate through that sometimes can feel like we're out in the dark. What else do we have here? We have the anchor, we have the letter, and we have the coffin. So these are things that we have transpired. These are stories that have transpired. These are stories that we tell ourselves. They are the things that make us who we are, parts of who we are, but not all of who we are. And the thing about Virgo energy is that it wants to process and to make sense of and to put into place the things that have occurred and that have happened so that they are used constructively, wisely, efficiently. And we are guided to take our time with that. We don't want to run away from this. We don't want to try to escape from this. We have the fox, we have the tower, and we also have the heart. These are things that we are fearful of. Spirit is truly talking about the darkness right now. It's talking about fear. It's talking about subconscious. It's talking about the wounds. It's talking about insecurities. It's talking about deceit, deception. This is coming from a place, not that it's foretelling it in your future, but it's freeing you from it, from your past. These are the things where we isolate our heart because we're afraid to put ourselves out there once again. We isolate and pull away from others or pull away from aspects within ourselves because we're afraid or we're conflicted at facing it once again. And at the time of the new moon, this maze is here. And it says, instead of running away from the subconscious, instead of, you know, beating yourself up because you don't have it all figured out, we want to invite you into this maze of life or into the maze of the subconscious or into the maze of the shadow self. And while you're navigating through that maze, you don't need to have it all figured out. You don't need to find a way out through the exit because a lot of it is about the experience. But we're going to encourage you to hold on to your own internal light. That's the other thing too with the new moon and with the appearance of the moon showing up twice. The moon is dark at the time of the new moon because the earth actually is in a position that blocks the light, not of the moon, but of the sun. The sun burns so brightly that its rays in the right position bounce off of the moon so that we here on earth can see it. Now, this is all about positioning. It's all about perspective, and it's also about timing. And if we think or believe that the moon or the sun or the light isn't there anymore, we can really trick ourselves into succumbing to the darkness and succumbing to our fears and succumbing to the fact that there is no more light in this earth, or there is no more light or hope or things to look forward to or things of value and substance of worth or my purpose, or this is the end of the line for me. When in reality, all that it is that you're seeing right then is just a wall or just your perspective at that time and place. So if you were to take a step back, a big step back, you would be able to see not only all of the paths of the maze, but you would also be able to see the exit, and it would make the path easier for you, right? But that's, unfortunately, as human beings, we don't get that. We have to really trust and embrace the rerouting, the ups and the downs, the ebbs and the flows, the trying things out. And as we're doing this for ourselves, we have to acknowledge that others are doing it as well. So we're going to cross paths with other people who are trying to figure it out. So I'm not entirely sure why that's the message that's coming through. Spirit, speak to us. The word that I just heard was healing. Also, we have male, the male counterpart just came through. The whip and the snake. So these are the things, this is what we desire. These are things that is that we want, but we are punishing ourselves for who we are not yet, or what we haven't done, what we haven't achieved, or relationships or things or loneliness or isolation. This is a very tough energy read kind of for me, because it shows me people who may be beating themselves up, punishing themselves because of their own expectations, punishing others, just being really harsh. And again, it comes from the subconscious. It comes from, but the other side to this is, if we read the story, there's more to the desires of this person's heart. There's more written in this book that may not have been read yet, but will ultimately be discovered. At the time of the new moon, I want you guys to set intention for discovery. I really, look, discovery. That's what's actually strong here, are the gifts here that are to be uncovered, that are to be recovered, that these treasures that are meant to be dug up while you're navigating through this path. For those of you guys that are, you know, focused on the masculine, whether the masculine within yourself or the masculine within another, there is a lot more to the surface that will be revealed to you, and that is not a threat. That's not a threat. Sometimes with the snake card here, we think of deceit, we think of lies and deception, and we try to beat it out of another person, or we try to beat it out of ourselves because we haven't figured it out, or we think or believe or know that something is off. We feel like they're not giving you their all, or that there's more to this that is missing, but soon things will be revealed. And in that process, it's your choices and your decisions. Are you going to allow yourself to allow this to eat you up? Or are you going to step into your masculine strength, which we all have, and declare what you want for yourself from a healthier space, from a space of love, from a space of light? Because I do see that mirroring outwards. Okay, so these are the cards that are jumping out. I hate to be cryptic, but yeah, look, become the true you. This is another thing too that I want you guys to hear and to know, is that as you are becoming more authentically you, which is going to be a process your entire life, you're going to discover new aspects within yourself. You're also going to be discovering aspects of another person, for those of you guys that are focusing on love and relationships. So as that person is finding out things about themselves and stepping into their own power and speaking their own truth, which may not be comfortable for them, we want to give them grace and softness and compassion while still also simultaneously honoring our own boundaries. I'm really getting this strong punishing vibe that's been coming through this entire reading that comes from not a space of love, but more of fear. And some of you guys are saying that you're equating boundaries with punishment, or boundaries with harsh restriction, or boundaries with being rude or mean or like cold. And that's simply not the case. Magnify your intentions. So this is when spirit wants you to, I'm getting the space of focus. When you can set an intention, 1000%, you can set an intention, but if your energy is scattered about, your intention has a hard time to manifest, because it's you're so scattered that your intentions become dull. The energy of them becomes dull. You want them to be magnetic. And the way to do that is to understand and know what you truly want, and to not force or not reconcile with, but try to convince it to come into your life, to convince it of your worth or your value. When you become the true you, which means coming back to the source of you, your state of being, you'll realize that you don't have to do anything other than be your authentic, truly loving, soft, vulnerable space. And by moving from a space of higher vibration and higher love, you act, and then focusing on exactly what it is that you want, you will then magnify your intentions. Either way, the magnification or the pull, the magnetism of it is not from you energetically pulling. Remember, the masculine energy came up. So we want to make sure that we are all demonstrating positive masculine traits and not toxic masculine traits, regardless of how we identify. So we are not forcing our will or pushing others or even entertaining toxic masculinity. Look, past life healing. So this is exactly what I'm saying. These, and it says, forget me not. I don't want to say the word curse, but it's similar to that, where it feels like these are the things that we hold on to that end up shaping our fears and shaping our present day experiences, which ultimately ends up shaping our future, because that's where we end up accepting, because we're either running from what we're afraid of or running towards it. So this is when we say, okay, by becoming the true you and by sitting and declaring and looking at the shadow sides of yourself and declaring what you want and focusing on that, you are giving yourself an opportunity to heal and to process the parts along the journey that you've experienced up until this point, instead of continually being triggered and moving from that reaction. This is really coming full circle. Look, wise soul. Now these two, I love how these two truly come together. Become the true you and wise soul. Your core nature is someone who is truly wise, who is truly vibrant, who doesn't have to say a whole lot in order to prove their point, or whatever they say is colorful and vibrant as is. I don't know why that's coming through, but I feel like some of you guys are spinning your wheels trying to convince yourself or tell this elaborate story when spirit is saying a little goes a long way, at least at this point along your journey. And this is, I think, because in this reflective state, you are going to be doing a lot of examination, which a lot of times looks like listening. Listening to yourself and listening to others, taking the time out to not rush to a decision or, rush to an outcome, but maybe taking your time with it, consulting your higher self, consulting your guides, talking to them, allowing it to simmer before you come to a conclusion, before you make a choice. And this is going to help you to tap into your inner wisdom. That is who you truly are. And the goal is to, along this labyrinth, along this maze of life, remember your wisdom, remember your strength, remember your compassion, remember your softness is actually your strength. What else do we have here? Look, we have lust. That is just too perfect. Deceit. Differences. Invisible. So honestly, guys, these feel like the seven deadly sins, but they're the shadow sins within yourself that you are reconciling with, the parts within you that you are confronting and facing. And these traits, I guarantee you, these traits have probably shown up in your relationships. They've shown up in your work habits, they've shown up in your self-care. Invisible is when we feel like we are not being seen, so we are either become really loud and like this fireworks show that's always trying to draw attention and eyes over to us, but it's actually coming from an insecure place. And then the opposite side of that is the person who doesn't want to be seen, doesn't want to be heard, but actually has a message and has, you know, some things that need to be said and some things that need to be shared. With the deceit, this is clearly about how others have lied to you, you ignoring your intuition and going along with things that you know are not true or things that don't feel right to your core state of being. Are you even lying to yourself or lying to others because the truth is too hard for you to face or too hard for you to hold? So you may be, and this may not be in what you're saying, but what you're doing, but or how you're showing up to the world, how you dress, how you hold yourself, your reaction. It's giving me very rising sign type of energy. This is when you look at your rising sign and say, this is my rising sign, and this is how I react to the world. What does this tell me about myself? And how do I become even more in alignment with my true state of being? How do I come in align with my true nature? Emphasis on the word nature, because it doesn't strive, it doesn't force, it just is. And whatever it is enough. Then we have lust. These are the things that we are desiring so strongly that don't come from a place of higher vibration or higher presence or higher essence, but we want them because we are trying to plug a hole within ourselves that is empty and needs something other than what we have and what we are. Or these are the opposite side of that is that we're denying ourselves the things that is that we truly want because we don't feel like we're worthy of receiving it. And then we have differences. This is when we don't allow ourselves to accept something or someone or ourselves for who they are. So we find all the ways to lie or to pull or whatever the case is in order to try and make something that's not meant to be together come together because we can't accept the fact that it is what it is. Or maybe you are trying so hard to be so different from others because you're afraid of intimacy and true connection. So you're finding all the things that are wrong so that you can't be hurt once again. Next card, we have the Poetess. I love every inch of my body, and I love the woman in my life fiercely. This is about sisterhood, and it's also about femininity, self-love, and acceptance. And again, this is regardless of how either one of us identify, but it's about finding people, women or men or however, and relating to them in a way that feels nurturing, supportive to our true state, our true nature. Our Lady of Guadalupe, the Empress of Protection. I am safe and divinely protected. I am held in love at all times. And that's a mantra that I really, truly feel like someone should receive right now. These are things that are going to help you at the time of the new moon, around the new moon, that are really going to help heal the wound if there is a wounded space. And then we have the Mystic of Peace. I am peace. When my mind is clear, the way is clear. And there's emphasis on the way is clear, the mind is clear. Remember how I was talking about perspective? So this, when we're talking about peace, my loves, peace does not mean the absence of chaos. It means that in the middle of chaos, in the midst of chaos, you can find and tap into the wise soul, the intuitive self, the higher self that knows that you are safe and divinely provided for and being protected, and that you are loved and lovable, and you don't have to do anything in order or be anything other than what you are, and you come, or you don't have to fight for things to be anything other than what they are, and there you surrender into a space and a state of peace. And that's what spirit wants to give to you at the time of the new moon. Because from this state of peace, you're going to be able to magnetize your intentions. Excuse me, guys. You're going to be able to magnify your intentions and magnetize them towards you. Simply just by focusing on them. And again, it's not about you knowing the way through this maze or the path being clear, because that's not a realistic expectation. Of course, the maze of life is not going to be clearly, you know, established for you and paved. You're going to want to, you know, reroute and get lost and try some things and see who you bump into and see how does this experience, like, how do I react in this experience? What does this show me about me? What is the magic of this? What is the magic of this experience? What are the gifts in this experience? Who can I gain? What can I live through? Like, life is really truly meant to be lived, and to live does not mean to do it in this perfectly positioned and placed outcome all the time. Virgo knows that perfection does not exist. In fact, a toxic Virgo energy is constantly trying to seek perfection and drives itself to the point of exhaustion or, you know, insanity, trying to reach an outcome or reach a goal that isn't feasible, to say the very least. So to expect perfection from your experiences, or expect perfection from yourself, or to expect perfection from your partner, or to expect perfection from your goals, it's painful and unrealistic. Look at this. Oh my goodness. How perfect. I'll leave that one. But the resting tree, patience and stillness, that's the darkness, my loves. Then we have the High Lord of gratitude and service, which, by the way, Virgo rules service and selflessness. Selflessness, humility, and conscious emphasis on conscious action. So you're taking the time to process, and you're not just reacting on instinct, because that instinct looks like it's coming from a more shadow side or unhealed place. And then the Shadow Queen, acquiring knowledge, and emphasis on the Shadow Queen, because that's exactly what I've been talking about from start to finish, and I've never seen these cards. Insecurity and manipulation. So with this, you guys, acquiring knowledge, this is saying there's two sides to this. There's the side of it that says, listen, you're not meant to have it all figured out. If you've been deceived, lied to, betrayed in the past, or you're trying to figure out your way along the path of life, you know, all of this is you gaining knowledge and gaining information. It's not a reflection of you. It's not a reflection of them or the circumstance. It just is what it is at that moment in time. And that can be an actual hard truth to sit with and to accept, because as human beings, we try in our brains to make connections in our logical mind, but the intuitive mind knows that the good or the bad doesn't define anything. It just is what it is. In fact, it's neither good nor bad. So we are guided, and this is really tough, but we are guided to embrace every single moment, good or bad, with gratitude and humility, and to, moving forward, make conscious choices and actions from a place of higher love and vibration. And the way to do that is not by initially reacting to it. And as I'm saying that, the incense is sizzling. So this is a really strong message that Spirit's trying to get to you right now. It's not by reacting on instinct or initial reaction. It's about resting first, having patience, so that you are not making choices and decisions based upon insecure doubts or limiting beliefs from things that have happened to you up until this point. And resting right now and being patient with where you're at along the path in your journey is going to reward you tenfold. Now, I know that I've said a lot in this reading already. I want to still shuffle cards, but I also want to draw your attention to the numbers that are on these cards. We have 22, which is my power number. And we also have 2, so we have 2, 2, 2 here. So at the time of the new moon, you are going to be coming into, look, we have an offering here, and it's coming in fast. Eight of Wands and the Knight of Cups. This card wants to jump out. Ace of Wands, and we have the Judgment card. So this is already saying that from the past experiences that have caused stress, discord, dysfunction, insecurities, things that you have walked away from. We have Nine of Wands and Eight of Cups here. You are actually being reborn again, renewed, re-emerging. And if that truly is the case, and this is happening under the lack of light at the new moon, the Virgo new moon, and it's happening so quick and so fast, and it's a beautiful offering, please take the time out to rest and to... And the thing too that I'm also hearing is also High Priestess. She learns how to work with the shadow and the light, by the way. She knows how to listen to both and work with both and marry the two of them by listening to her intuition first and foremost. But the one thing too that I'm hearing is even as you're resting, you're also resting your energy. Again, it's a mirror. So as you rest and as you disengage from conflict or from your initial reaction that other people may be expecting or from your own disappointment with how others or how certain circumstances may or may not be unfolding, you allow that situation, as you're resting, you allow that situation to rest, and it literally will open up a gate, a portal, fast, very, very quickly. And the High Priestess absolutely understands and knows that. That's a part of working your magic, and that's also about magnetizing your intentions. All right, my loves, thank you so much for tuning in to listen to this intuitive message for the Virgo new moon. I know it's a little different than we normally do, but please let me know if it works for you. Chariot here is working with, again, the dark and the light in order to make moves and to move forward and to be successful in that, to be absolutely successful in the last word I heard was determination. To your determination and your will to be successful is going to be everything that you need in order to carry this chariot forward. All right, I'm sending you guys all of my loves. I have a candle lit here for us to start, because of course I'm starting my intentions early for the Virgo new moon. I'm a Virgo myself. I'll be working my magic. I'm going to invite you to browse the apothecary for your own fix candles that I fix by hand, and also the oils that you can use in order to anoint your body or your intentions within your own life. All of those things are available to you at bahatilife.com. Anything else that says that it's from me is a scam. There's only one authentic source for those oils and my magic, and that again is bahatilife.com. Until then, you guys, I'm sending you guys all of my love and all of my blessings, and I can't wait to see you in the next video. Bye.